Chef Eric from Dunkin Donuts is here. All right, brace yourself. Fried chicken and a croissant donut waffle.
That's right.
Whew. Man, that sounds like a good one. Plus, we're going to welcome Janet in here in a little bit, and she's going to make a granola using the passion fruit,
the mango passion fruit colada.
There's a lot of stuff going on in here. I can't keep it straight.
It's so many good ingredients. Yeah, so let me walk you through the ingredients that we have here today.
Please.
So the first thing we're going to start mom off with is the mango passion fruit colada granola. So granola, really easy to make, and you probably have most of these ingredients at home.
Mm-hmm.
Just don't forget to pick up your culotta,
and
Janet's going to walk you through how to make the granola.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, we have oats and puffed wheat and rice and dried fruits, and we're going to toss that together and make a nice granola, and then a parfait.
Yum.
And then
you see some coconut there, too. I love that.
Yeah, it's going to be great. I tasted it earlier. Janet did a wonderful job.
Always nice to be a taste tester, right?
So then, the main course we're going to serve mom on Mother's Day is chicken and waffles with a Dunkin twist using our croissant donut. We're going to turn that into a waffle, and I'll show you how to do that a little later.
I'm excited to find out. All right, and then the ingredients that we need for the fried chicken?
Yeah, so we have chicken. You can either use chicken breast or chicken thighs, and I like to brine it. It gives it a lot more flavor, so I have some ingredients here to brine it, another word to say marinade. And then we're going to top that off with a maple coffee syrup using our Dunkin' Dark Roast.
Wow. So there's a lot to do. We're going to be very busy in the kitchen, and of course you can find the recipe online, but we'll come back and get to it.
For now, we want to send it back into the kitchen. I'm going to enjoy the chocolate chip donut from Dunkin', and Will's going to work on something new with Dunkin'.
I think you've had about five or six of those donuts already. Janet Rock is with me. Dunkin' Donuts is the place everybody knows. Mango passion fruit colada granola is what we're going to make.
Exactly.
Okay. It's like, wow.
When you hear that. And it's so yummy, and it's great for everybody to share.
All right. Well,
and
we
it's
don't
great.
Have to share. Okay.
All right. What we can do,
yes.
If you'd like to start building, I have some already cooked off.
Okay.
You can build a parfait while I start assembling the ingredients
on how we can make the granola. Is there any thing that needs to go first, second, or third, or is it kind of like, you know, freestyle?
This is freestyle.
Okay,
and this
freestyle.
Is a great activity to do with the kids in the morning as well.
Like this? Put a little
so we always start with building a syrup using our Dunkin' Donuts mango passion fruit colada.
Which is delicious.
It is. It's very refreshing, great for the springtime.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to make a syrup with that, and I'm going to add that to my saucepan with a little oil and a little sugar.
Okay.
And then that's going to come to a boil. We're going to let that reduce down a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And while that's going on, we are going to assemble the dry ingredients.
Okay. And you have a bunch of different things over there, too.
I do. A lot of this stuff you already have in your cupboard, and you can put whatever you feel like in your granola.
I love granola.
The base is usually rolled oats.
Mm-hmm.
Puffed wheat, puffed rice.
Okay.
And then some nuts and some dried fruit. And I also have some coconut because I like coconut, with my mango passion fruit.
I'm with you.
So we add all of this to our pan.
Mm-hmm. That's good.
And then we'll add our syrup on top of this.
You know, the good thing is it's a great way to get the kids started in the day. They've got a bunch of different things in there that they can, you know, kind of have on the run if they need to.
And that's the wonderful thing about granola.
Right.
You can eat it as a cereal. You can build a beautiful parfait like you're doing
right there.
Look at me, huh? It's gorgeous. And you can also snack on it.
Right,
so it's great for breakfast, snack, or lunch.
Right.
It's wonderful.
Okay. So we got that here.
Yeah.
Continue to build over here.
Right, and then we just add our syrup right over our dry ingredients. And I like to do this the day before.
And let it sit for a little
while? And let it sit for a little while in the refrigerator.
Okay.
And after it's kind of soaked up all of those syrups, those sauces. And then I simply spread it out on a sheet tray, and I toast it in the oven for a couple of hours.
What should the oven be on?
The oven should be about 175 to 200 degrees.
Because you don't want to overdo it, and you don't want it to burn or anything else, to really kind of keep a close eye on it.
Nice and slow is the way to go.
Okay, that's good. And that's what's going to bring this dark, rich color to it?
It does. And it just brings out some of the fruity notes and the toasted notes. And it's wonderful to start the day.
And even this alone here, you can just pack little baggies for the kids on their way out and
Absolutely, much better
than some of the other stuff.
Absolutely.
That they have. Looks good to me. Actually, I think I did a pretty good job on my.
That's stellar.
There you go.
Beautiful.
Nice job. Here we go. We're going to put this together, talk about the other great things, and we're also going to make some fried chicken. Can't wait for that either. Back to you.
Wow, this is great. Really taking me down. Yeah. Every opportunity.
We're in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Chef Eric is here. We're giving him a hard time. Text your friends at Dunkin' Donuts. We got fried chicken and croissant waffles on the menu. Oh, let me tell you, when Dunkin' Donuts comes in, they do not fool around.
No.
They, like, do it big time every time they come in, and that's what we're going to do today.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're going to do it.
Thanks for being a good sport.
No problem. We're going to do it big today again because it's Mother's Day. So we're going to start off with Janet's nice mango passion fruit culotta granola. It's a mouthful. And then we're going to move into chicken and waffles.
Yeah,
the classic dish, southern dish, but we're going to do it in a Dunkin' twist.
Okay.
So we're going to take our croissant donut, our brand new croissant donut, and we're just going to smush it in the waffle iron and make a waffle out of that.
Oh, okay.
And then what we're going to do is fry some chicken.
Okay.
So let's just get started.
So what do we need to do to get this all rocking?
Yeah, let's get started. So we're going to make a maple Dunkin' dark roast syrup for the top. So if you could go ahead and start that, that'd be awesome.
I'm gonna support this
and I've already started the brine here. I like to brine the chicken, makes it nice and moist and flavorful. And it's just a traditional fry technique. So you're gonna dunk it in the flour.
Got it.
And then you're gonna put it in the buttermilk.
Ooh, buttermilk.
Yeah, buttermilk. And then back in the flour. So wet, dry, wet, dry.
Look at that.
Yeah. And so,
well, so we got this here.
Yep. So we're gonna reduce that. Mm-hmm. And your task now is to make the waffle out of the croissant donut.
Okay.
And it's just a technique. You just smoosh it down.
So we'll put this in here, and this is a... Put that right in. Are we doing one at a time, or can we do a couple?
Let's do one at a time. It's a little safer. I haven't really experimented with two.
Let's go wild!
Yeah.
All right, we got that in there?
Yeah, just smoosh it down.
You have a pretty professional waffle iron there.
Yeah.
It has four different sections. You can make tiny waffles. But this is something, any type of waffle iron that you have at home.
Yeah.
Just give it a smush.
Yeah, just give it a smush.
You want those marks on it, right?
Yeah, you just want to make it look like a waffle and just sort of just leave it in there for a minute or so.
Okay.
And, it's gonna. What happens is the nice glaze on our croissant donut gets like really hard and candy-like. So really taking chicken and waffles to a whole new level.
There you go. Sounds
an
good.
Extra crispy element.
And I like to fry my chicken in a cast iron pan.
I think that really is key to a lot of things. It adds a lot of great flavor from everything that may have been cooked before, and just really crisps it up nice.
Yep. And so just be careful when you're at home. You want this oil at 375.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. If it's too cold, it's just going to absorb the oil.
Mm-hmm.
And if it's too hot, it's just going to be dangerous.
Okay.
So,
especially if you got little ones running around and curious as to what you're making or doing.
That's right. They can help make the granola in the morning.
Yes, make it perfect.
So we have everything going here. It's great. Maybe we can pull out the waffle now.
Give this a shot. Oh, look at that.
Yeah.
Mm.
So you can see how it caramelized up really nicely.
Yes, this is something that you don't want to bite immediately into.
No.
Absolutely
not.
Because you won't be able to taste any of your other bites for the rest of the day.
Take another one of these. Put it in here.
Yep. Give it a squish.
Squish this down.
Yum.
Perfect.
Sizzling away.
And this is so great. For me, Mother's Day is all about a nice brunch.
Yeah.
You know, and why not make it at home and do something fun with ingredients that you already like? You know, taking your products.
Especially Dunkin' ingredients. It really, as you can see, it makes a wonderful Mother's Day brunch.
Mm-hmm.
And so after you've spoiled mom in the morning with this nice brunch and you're on your walk in the afternoon, we have this great springtime, summertime sandwich that's out now. It's bacon, egg, and cheese, and we made a fresh guacamole.
We saw
right on top. Yeah, it's delicious.
We were at Dunkin', and we were looking at the picture going, oh, my God, that looks so good.
Mm-hmm.
It's unbelievable.
Yeah.
So you can spoil mom all day with Dunkin'.
Definitely.
Good.
You have some finished presentations here, right? Let's bring out these are the...
I'm going to take this one out here.
The granola parfaits. Take a look at those, that fresh fruit.
And here we have the finished product of the waffle.
Man.
So here you have the nice maple coffee, Dunkin' coffee syrup.
A little confection sugar, a little fruit. Man, you're definitely going
to
want these recipes.
Go.
If you do, head on over to roadshow.com.